The golden whistler, or Pachycephala pectoralis, is a bird endemic to Australia. And because of that, the bird has also known by the name the Australian golden whistler. However, their taxonomy is very complex. Some authorities consider the golden whistler to consist of about 59 subspecies, with a very wide distribution area, including Indonesia, Fiji, Papua New Guinea, Solomons, and Australia. But on the other hand, some of them consider that most of the 59 subspecies are independent species. And now, let's take a look at the release of a golden whistler on the aviary.
It's the aviary!
Hi guys. Today we will release a yellow bird with a black necklace, white chin, and olive wings. What is the name? His name is Golden Whistler. But in Indonesia, it is better known as Conchalon Emas.
Golden Whistler.
But how did the bird get here? So, the other day, I happened to find him in a weak state. It's like dying. Then I decided to treat and take care of him until finally, the bird was healthy, able to roost and eat on his own. So, guys, there are some birds here that come from the outside, and we brought them here to save them. There are birds that people have cared for since childhood, but they never let them fly. In the end, here they are trained to fly. Some birds can't survive out there. And one of them is this, the golden whistler. All right, let's release this bird. Ready? We release the golden whistler now. Hopefully, the golden whistler is able to fly well.
Biasa, action dulu.
The golden whistler is a songbird with a melodious voice with a length of only 17 centimeters, with colorful feathers attached to their bodies. Their appearance is indeed a feast for the eyes. But that color variation only applies to male birds, because female golden whistlers are mostly gray. As previously mentioned, the golden whistler has a fairly wide distribution area. In Indonesia, they are found on many islands, including Java, Bali, Sulawesi, Nusa Tenggara, to Papua. They can also be found in almost all forest habitats, both in the lowlands and mountains, with an altitude of up to 14.0 above sea level. They are also sometimes seen in gardens or plantation areas. Even so, their favorite habitat is dense forest. They belong to the type of settler bird and only migrate from the lowlands to higher lands when winter arrives. When in the wild, these birds usually live and forage alone, with their diet mostly obtained from lower and middle tree levels. But when they forage in groups, Their groups also contain birds of other species. Their main diet is insects, especially caterpillars, grasshoppers, spiders, and other small arthropods. However, they also often eat berries. Golden whistlers sometimes perch quietly among the leaves of trees or shrubs, but their bright color makes them visible quite easily. Even if you have trouble finding them, just wait until they make their beautiful, loud singing. Their singing whistles can even be heard from hundreds of meters away. And usually, they sound in a fairly long duration. The mating season of the golden whistler occurs between September to January. Both male and female birds are responsible for building a shallow bowl-shaped nest made of twigs, tree bark, and grass. The materials are tied with cobwebs and covered with fine grass. The nest is placed in trees or bushes at a distance of about 6 meters from the ground. Both parents play a role in incubating the eggs, which hatch after 15 days, and caring for their chicks. Though, in a season, usually, only one brood is raised. Young birds will fledge when they are about 12 days old. The IUCN classifies the golden whistler into the category of least concern, and they are commonly found in the wild. However, their population has declined for several years due to habitat destruction. This aviary has only one male golden whistler. But hopefully, in the near future, we can bring in a mating partner for him so that he can have chicks as soon as possible. And in turn, their chicks will fill the forests of Indonesia in the future. Hopefully so.